Good morning, children. This is lecture 2 of chapter machines. In this lecture, we will study about pulley. We will start with the definition of pulley. What is a pulley? A pulley is a grooved wheel with a rope, chain, or cable running along the groove. Pulley may be fixed and movable. We are having two types of pulley: fixed pulley and movable pulley. A fixed pulley is similar to a first class lever. The wheel is the fulcrum and the rope on both sides is the effort and resistance. A fixed pulley is attached to something that doesn't move, like a ceiling or wall. For example, elevator. It is having a pulley and one side is the effort and other side is the resistance, that is the load. Fixed pulleys do not increase force. They only use to change the direction of the effort. And they are having small mechanical advantage. Two fixed pulleys are shown here. These pulleys are fixed in two points. This is fixed in this point and this is fixed in this point. And both the figures, they are having grooved wheel with rope. These are the grooved wheel. And both are having rope. One side of the rope is effort and another side of the rope is having load. So they are only changing the direction of the effort, but it is not acting as a force multiplier. Mechanical advantage, velocity ratio and efficiency of a single fixed pulley. This is the diagram of a single fixed pulley. This is the rigid support. With this, there is a frame and this is your grooved wheel. In that grooved wheel, there is a rope. Now, this is the rope. This is the rope. Now, in the rope, in the left-hand side, load is there, here. And here it is effort. Both load and effort are acting in the downward direction. Now, the string, it is having a tension which is on both the sides of the rope and acting in the upward direction. Now this, the tension of the rope which is acting in the upward direction and the downward direction forces, that is load and effort, they balance each other. If the tension of the rope is not there, suppose it is not there, then because of the downward force acting by load and effort, the rope will come down only. So the tension is playing a very important role here. So you have to, whenever you will show the pulley, you will draw the pulley system, the rope and with the tension that is in the upward direction, this showing of this tension is very important if you are drawing a fixed pulley or a movable pulley, whatever it may be. So there are two tension which is acting vertically upward and the load and the effort, they are acting vertically downward. Now let us see what is written here. The figure shows a single fixed pulley. The axle is fixed to a support and a negligible mass string pass around the grooved rim of the pulley. It's the rope is having negligible mass. One end of the string is connected to load, as I told you, in the left hand side, and the other end to the effort, the right hand side, in this figure. Both load and effort act downwards, as I told you. On pulling the string downward, the load moves up. If you pull the rope from the right hand side, then the load will moves up. The tension throughout the string is T because it is only a single rope. So throughout the rope, the tension is T. The friction between the string and the rim rotates the pulley when the string is pulled down. Am I clear? Now, in balanced position, for this type of pulley, load is equals to tension. These two are balancing each other. The tension in the upward direction and the load in the downward direction, they balance each other. And in the right hand side, effort is balanced by tension. So effort is equals to T. Now L is equals to T and effort is equals to T. So from in this two, load is equal to effort. Now mechanical advantage, as you know, mechanical advantage is equal to load by effort. Now load and effort both are equal. So load by effort, see here, load by effort is equal to T by T because both are equals to T. So mechanical advantage of this type of pulley is 1. So there is no gain in mechanical advantage for this fixed pulley. Then why we are using this type of pulley? If the mechanical advantage is not there, there is no gain in mechanical advantage. So why we are using this type of pulley? This type of pulley is used to change the direction of the effort. That means we are pulling the rope in the downward direction and the load moves up. If E moves a distance D downward, that means if this effort moves a distance D downward, load also moves same distance D but in the upward direction. So thus, distance moved by the effort is equals to D. Similarly, distance moved by the load is equals to D. So velocity ratio is equal to distance moved by the effort by distance moved by the load. Both are D and D. So velocity ratio is also equals to 1. If the mechanical advantage is equals to 1 and the velocity ratio is equals to 1, therefore efficiency is equals to mechanical advantage by velocity ratio. So it is 1 and 100%. So the mechanical advantage and the velocity ratio of a single fixed pulley is 1 and the efficiency is 100%. In actual practice, however, there is some friction at the axle or in the pulley bearing. So the effort needed is little more than the load to be lifted. In actual practice, there is some friction always present in the pulley bearings. So what is the effort that is needed will be little more than the load to be lifted. Thus, the mechanical advantage is less than 1. Now you have seen that, the last slide only you have seen, this type of pulley, the load is balanced by 1 tension and effort is also balanced by 1 tension. So the mechanical advantage of this type of pulley is given by load by effort, which is equals to T by T, which is equals to 1. But we can see that because of the friction, the mechanical advantage is less than 1. But the velocity ratio is equals to distance moved by the effort by distance moved by the load. This is not changing. It is as it is D by D, so it is equals to 1. So velocity ratio is 1. So from this 2, if I am taking the efficiency, efficiency is equal to mechanical advantage by velocity ratio. As mechanical advantage is less than 1, we are not getting efficiency as 100%. Efficiency is always less than 100%. It is not equal to 100%. So if the efficiency is also not equals to 100%, mechanical advantage is not equals to 1, then why this type of pulley is used? There is no gain either in mechanical advantage or in speed. So why this type of pulley is used? A fixed pulley is used only to change the direction of effort to be applied. That is, with its use, the effort can be applied in a more convenient direction. Now, it is difficult to apply effort upwards to lift a load up directly. But it becomes easier with the help of a fixed pulley because effort can now be applied in downward direction to raise the load up. Therefore, to apply the effort downward, one can conveniently make use of one's own weight also for effort. I think you have understood. Movable pulley. A movable pulley is one in which one end of the rope is fixed and the wheel is free to move. Movable pulley do increase force and therefore can have a large mechanical advantage. In the following slides, we will see about the movable pulleys. These are the figure showing movable pulleys. Now, movable pulleys, one end of the string is fixed. Already I told you that. See here, this is the side. The string is fixed in this rigid support. And for this also, the string is fixed in the rigid support. And now, this is the movable pulley. This is also the movable pulley. And the load is hanging from the movable pulley with the help of a hook. And this side, the effort is acting. Here also, this side, the effort is acting. Mechanical advantage, velocity ratio, and efficiency of a single movable pulley. Now, this is the figure showing a single movable pulley. In this, the string, one end of the string is fixed with a rigid support. There is a hook H. With that hook, the string is suspended. The other end of the string, the effort is applied and the effort is applied in the upward direction. With the help of a frame from the pulley, the load is suspended and the load is acting vertically downward. Now in this figure, you can see that the load is supported by the string from both the sides, from two sides. So that means one load is balanced by two tension. One is in the left hand side and another is in the right hand side. The left hand side string is also having a tension T and the left right hand side string is also having a tension T. So the load is balanced by two tensions and the effort is balanced by only one tension. It is shown here, T is equals to E. Now let me see what is written here. Adjacent figure shows a single movable pulley suspended by passing an inextensible string of negligible mass around the groove. The string is having negligible mass. One end of the string is suspended to hook H at a rigid support and the effort E is applied at its free end. This is, as I told you, tension T acts on the string on both sides. Tension T, this is one tension, this is one tension and this is another tension. This is one tension and this is another tension. So the tension T acts on the string on both sides of the pulley as shown. Load L is balanced by tension T at both segment. This is known as one segment. This side is one segment and this side is another segment. Two segment of the string. As I told you, the load is balanced by tension T at both segment of the string. And the effort E is balanced by T at its free end. I have already shown it to you. Now come here. Load is balanced by T plus T. As I told you, in both the segments, the tension is there and the load is balanced by segment tension on both the segments. That is 2T. So load is equals to 2T. And effort is equals to only 1T. Okay, so from here I can get effort is equals to L by 2, because I can write it as L is equals to 2T. So T is equals to L by 2 and effort is equals to T. In place of T you put down, write E is equals to L by 2. So I'm getting E is equals to L by 2. Now from here mechanical advantage is equals to 2T by T is equals to 2. So the single movable pulley acts as a force multiplier, because mechanical advantage is greater than 1. We are getting mechanical advantage greater than 1. So it is acting as a force multiplier. Now when the free end of the string is pulled up by a distance D, the load is raised up through a distance d by 2. If the effort is pulled by a distance d in the upward direction, load will only go up to, it will cover a distance d by 2. So thus, when dE is equals to d, dL is equals to d by 2. So from there, velocity ratio is equal to dE by dL, as we know. So it is d by d by 2, so it is also equals to 2. So now efficiency is equal to mechanical advantage by velocity ratio. Mechanical advantage we are getting 2, velocity ratio also we are getting 2, which is nothing but 1, or efficiency is 100%. Am I clear to you? Now for an actual single movable pulley, due to number 1, friction in the pulley bearing or at the axle, or number 2, the weight of the pulley and the string, the effort needed to lift up a load L will be more than L by 2. So the mechanical advantage is less than 2. Since the velocity ratio remains 2, because velocity ratio is not changing, only the mechanical advantage is changing. Velocity ratio is something related with the distance traveled. Okay, distance covered. So velocity ratio remains 2, hence the efficiency will be less than 1 or 100% in a single movable pulley. Theoretically it is 100%, but practically it is less than 100%. Changing direction of effort using a single movable pulley, actually you know what is happening. You have seen in the last slide that with a single movable pulley, the effort has to be applied in the upward direction, which is very inconvenient. If you have to apply the effort in the upward direction, it is not at all convenient position. So to make it convenient, what actually we are doing, we are fixing a single fixed pulley with a single movable pulley. As you know that single fixed pulley is not changing the mechanical advantage. Single fixed pulley is only used to change the direction of the effort. So see the figure. This is a single movable pulley which is denoted by A. The string of this single movable pulley, this string is attached with the single fixed pulley which is denoted as B, and now you can see the effort is acting in the downward direction, which is very very convenient. And if I am adding one fixed pulley with a movable pulley, it is not changing the mechanical advantage, neither the velocity ratio of the single movable pulley. So we can do that for our convenience. The load is attached with the single movable pulley only. Am I clear? Now the effort is again balanced by this T. Only one T. And the load is balanced by this T and this T. So that means it is as it is like the single movable pulley. Okay, let me see what is written here. With a single movable pulley, the effort is to be applied in that upward direction, as I told you. However, it is inconvenient to apply effort in the upward direction, Therefore, a movable pulley A is used along with a fixed pulley B. Why? To change the direction of the effort as shown in the figure. Only to change the direction of the effort. The load is attached to the axle of a movable pulley A, as I told you, and the effort is applied in the downward direction. See here in the figure. At the free end of the string passing over the fixed pulley B, one can use his own weight as effort, which will be quite convenient. You can use your own weight as effort. That means you can pull the rope, pull the string. You can use your own weight. The mechanical advantage and the velocity ratio of this arrangement shown in the figure remain the same as that of a single movable pulley. That is, mechanical advantage is equals to 2 and velocity ratio is equals to 2. So nothing is changing. So for our convenience, we can use a single fixed pulley with a single movable pulley only to change the direction of the effort. Block and tackle system. Block and tackle system is a combination of fixed and movable pulleys. In this system of pulleys, two blocks of pulleys are used. The upper block has several pulleys attached to a rigid support, and the lower block has several movable pulleys. This arrangement is called block and tackle system. Now, for convenience of applying effort in the downward direction, the number of movable pulleys in the lower block is either equal to or one less than the number of pulleys in the fixed upper block. The adjacent figure shows a typical block and tackle system. Just look at this figure. Now, this is one block and this is another block. This is upper block, this is upper block. Upper block is fixed with a rigid support. These are the fixed pulleys, this is and this one. And the lower one is a movable pulley. Now you can see that the upper block is having two pulleys, this one and this one, this one and this one. And the lower block is having one less than this two. And these three pulleys are attached, that means these two blocks are attached with a string, single string. You can see that this string is starting from the lower end. It is just going through the first pulley of this upper block, and then again it is coming here, and then it is passing through the lower pulley, and then it is just going up, and again it is coming from the upper pulley, the first, second pulley of the upper block, and this is the effort. And the load is attached with the movable pulley, and the load is acting in the downward direction. There should be an arrow. Am I clear? This is a block and tackle system for five pulleys. Let us see the figure. In this figure, you can see there are two blocks. This is one block, this is upper block, and this is the lower block. Now, upper block, the pulleys, there are three pulleys which are fixed pulleys. And in the lower block, there are two pulleys which are movable pulleys. So, total there are five pulleys. Now, these two blocks are attached with a single string. Each segment of the string is having tension T. Now, the load is attached with the movable pulley, and it is acting in the downward direction. So this direction, the direction of the load direction of the effort is very important to give. And the effort is acting in the free end of the stream. Okay, let me see what is written here. Adjacent figure shows a block and tackle of system of 5 pulleys, in which one end of the string is attached to the hook of the upper block. The load L attached to the movable lower block, and the effort E is applied at the free end, that means this one, free end of the string. The tension along the entire length of the string is same, and it is denoted by T because we are having only one string. In the adjacent figure, the tension in the 5 segment of the string is supported the load. Now the load is supported by the 5 segment of the string. Okay, so load is supported by 5T because it is supported by 5 segment of the string. And the effort is supported by only 1T. So E is equal to T. From here, E is equals to L by 5. How to calculate? L is equals to 5T. Or from here you can write here T is equals to L by 5. Now put this value here. E is equals to T. Now T is equals to L by 5. So E is equals to L by 5. See this one. Now mechanical advantage is equals to L by E. L is equals to 5T by effort is equals to T. So mechanical advantage of this type of pulley is 5. Okay, so it is acting as a force multiplier. Now let me just show you how to draw this pulley, because drawing of pulley is coming in the exam. You will draw a rigid support. Maybe my drawing will not good here. Now draw like this and this two block. Now the first block is having like this. There will be a hook. There will be a hook. Okay. Now this one is having two pulleys. And there will be a load. Okay. Now the string, you have to start the string attached from here. Here to here it will go. Now from here it will come here. From this it will go to this one. Oh, this one. Then it will come from here to here. Then it will go straight and it will come and it will come here like this. But the string should be straight. String should not bend. My diagram, my drawing is not good. But you please do properly. And each string, each segment is having tension. This is having tension T. This is having tension T. This is having tension T. This one is also having tension T. This one is having tension T. This is also having tension T. And this is your effort. Now you can see that load is balanced by this T, this T, it balanced by this t, this one, and this one, not this one. You can see that load is balanced by this 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Not this one. Not this one. This is in the downward like that, the last string. Effort is balanced by this tension. Am I clear? So load is balanced by 5T. And effort is balanced by only 1T. Have you understood, children? Now this is block and tackle for 4 pulleys. See the figure. Now in this figure, you can see there are 2 blocks. This is upper block and this is the lower block. Each block carries 2 pulleys, is having 2 pulleys. The lower block, 2 pulleys are movable pulleys, and the upper blocks, 2 pulleys are fixed pulleys. There is a single string. It is going around the pulleys. Now, it is starting from the upper block because I have to bring the effort in the downward direction. As there are same number of pulleys. How to draw this? Let me just show you how to draw this. Draw a rigid support and then 2 blocks. This is one block and this is another block. Each block is having 2 pulleys. 1, 2. There is a hook. There is a hook. It is also having 2 pulleys. Load will be here. Downward direction. Now the string has to be attached from the upper pulley. So it will come from here. It will go from here straight. Then again it will come from here. It will go from here. It will go up straight and it will come down. So effort is here. Tension is acting here. This segment is also having tension T. This segment is also having tension T. This segment is having tension T. This segment is also having tension T. Now you can see that the load is balanced by 4T. That means this one, this one, this one, this one, and this one. This is not taking. This one is not responsible for the load. This tension is balanced by effort. Otherwise, you can say that effort is balanced by one tension. Now, see what is written. Adjacent figure shows a block and tackle system for 4 pulleys, in which one end of the string is attached to the hook of the upper block. The load L attached to the movable lower block and the effort E is applied at the free end of the string. The tension along the entire length of the string is same and is denoted by T. The tension in 4 segment of the string supports the load. Therefore, L is equals to 4T and E is equals to T. Therefore, L is equals to L by 4 and mechanical advantage L by E. So, it is 4T by T. So, mechanical advantage is 4. That means mechanical advantage is equals to the number of pulleys that we are getting. Last slide also we have seen the mechanical advantage we are getting is equals to 5 if you are having 5 number of pulleys. Here we are getting 4 because we are having 4 number of pulleys. Am I clear to you? This diagram I'm showing because these are very important in the exam. Draw the diagram of the four pulleys, five pulleys is coming. Now, in general, if the total number of pulleys used in both the block is n, both the block is n, and the effort is applied in the downward direction, then the tension in n segment of string supports the load. That means L is equals to nt. If I am having 5 pulleys, therefore L is equals to 5t. If I am having 4 pulleys, L is equals to 4t. And effort is equals to t, or L is equals to L by n. Thus, for effort required to balance the load is, effort is equals to L, that means load, by number of pulleys. Thus, in a block and tackle system, the effort gets multiplied n times. Effort get multiplied n times, where n is the total number of pulleys in the system. It therefore acts as a force multiplier. Hence, mechanical advantage is equal to load by effort. Load is equals to nt, as I told you, and effort is equals to t. So, mechanical advantage is equals to n. We have seen that if there are 5 pulleys, then mechanical advantage is coming out as 5. If there are 4 pulleys, mechanical advantage is coming out as 4. That means total number of pulleys in both the blocks. Now, the velocity ratio. In a system of n pulleys, if the load moves up through a distance d, each segment of the string support the load is loosened by the length t. So, the effort end moves through a distance nd. Each segment of the string that is supporting the load is loosened by a length d. If dl is equals to d, that means distance moved by the load is equals to d, then distance moved by the effort will be nd. That means n is the number of pulleys, nd. Am I clear? So, velocity ratio is equals to dE by dl, distance moved by the effort by distance moved by the load. Now, distance moved by the effort is nd, so nd by d, which is nothing but E. So, velocity ratio is equals to number of pulleys. Thus, the velocity ratio is always equal to the number of strands of tackle or number of section of the string supporting the load. Okay, this is very important. The velocity ratio is always equal to the number of strands of the tackle or the number of section of the string that is supporting the load. If there are 5 pulleys, the load is supported by 5 segments of the string. So, velocity ratio is equals to 5. Am I clear? So, efficiency is equals to MA by VR, mechanical advantage by velocity ratio. Now, mechanical advantage also we are getting N, and velocity ratio also we are getting N. So, it is equals to 1 or 100%. Efficiency is 100% only in an ideal situation. But in actual practice, there is always some friction in the bearings of pulleys, and also the weight of the string and the weight of the lower block of the pulleys is not negligible. So, the mechanical advantage decreases and hence the efficiency decreases. It is not 100%. This is a very important question. Am I clear? The pulley system is only a force multiplier. It's only a force multiplier. And just like other machines, there is no gain in energy. This can be seen as follows. The work done by the effort, that is input energy. Work done is nothing but energy, is effort into distance moved by the effort. That is E into ND. We have done the distance moved by the effort is ND. So effort into distance moved by the effort is equals to E into ND. So NED. And the work done on the load, that is output energy. Load into distance moved by the load. That is load is L and the distance moved by the load is D. So L is equals to NE. L is equals to N into E and D. So it is NED. Okay. From where we have got, because MA is equals to L by E. And that is nothing but N. So from there, L is equals to NE. L is equals to NE. Okay. So I can write here L is equals to NE. Is equals to NED. Am I clear? Thus, there is no gain in energy. Because work done by the effort, that is input energy, is also equals to NED. Output energy is also equals to NED. So there is no gain in energy. It is acting as a force multiplier. Effect of weight of pulley on mechanical advantage, velocity ratio and efficiency. Till now, whatever we have done, whatever we have discussed about the pulley, we have not taken the weight of the pulley into consideration. But pulley is also having some weight. So if we take that weight of pulley, then this will also having some effect on mechanical advantage, velocity ratio and efficiency. But unless and until it is said to you while doing the numericals, you will not consider the weight of the pulley. But there is the weight of the pulley is acting. Let us see what is happening with the weight of the pulley on mechanical advantage, velocity ratio and efficiency. What is the effect? Consider a system of N pulleys. Let W be the total weight of the lower block along with the pulley in it. Lower block, because it is the movable one. The upper block is the fixed one. So lower block is only coming into play a role. In the balance position, E is equals to T. And whatever we were saying that L is equals to NT, it will now become L plus W, because weight of the pulley I am taking. So L plus W is equals to NT. That I have written here. Now from here, from this one, L is equals to, from this one, L is equals to NT minus W. Now NT is equals to E is equals to T. So in place of T, I can write E. So it is NE by NE minus W. Now mechanical advantage is equals to L by E. L is equals to NE minus W by E. Now just separate it. NE by E minus W by E. So EE gets cancelled. It is becoming N minus W by E. Now see here N minus W by E. That means previously we were getting mechanical advantage is equals to N. Now there is a term W by E is now subtracted from N. W by E. That means the mechanical advantage is always less than the ideal value N. That means this much amount is less than N. So the velocity ratio does not change because it is the distance moved by the effort and the load. So it remains N. But the mechanical advantage is decreasing. It is not N now. There is a factor W by E which is subtracted from N. So that means I'm not getting the efficiency also 100%. So velocity ratio is equals to n. Now what I'm getting mechanical advantage, I'm getting n minus W by E, and I'm getting velocity ratio is equals to n. Therefore efficiency is equals to mechanical advantage by velocity ratio. So mechanical advantage is equal to n minus W by E by n. Now again you separate it, so it will be n by n minus W by E into n. N n gets cancelled, so 1 minus W by NE, that I have got. That means efficiency eta is not 1, it is efficiency eta is equal to 1 minus W by NE. So W by NE is the factor which is subtracted from 1. So that means the efficiency is not 100%. Thus the efficiency is reduced. Why? Due to the weight of the lower block of pulleys. More the weight of the lower block, less is the efficiency. For greater efficiency, the pulleys in the lower block should be as light as possible. And the friction in the bearing of pulleys should be minimized by use of lubricants. Okay, how to minimize? Now it is given comparison between a fixed, single fixed pulley and a single movable pulley. Please go through it. I think you will be able to understand what is written here. Now with this, I'm ending lecture 2 of machine chapter here only. And next class, we shall solve some numericals on pulleys.